their serving these this week with our brown sushi rice. And those, it's one of the actual meals in our plan that dropped yesterday. If you're new to Batch Cooking Club, welcome. Thanks for joining us. We're here every Thursday live with a cooking class featuring one of the recipes from our weekly plans that drop every Wednesday around 9 a.m. Pacific Standard Time. Shout out to any of our members and to our community. Thank you for being here. If you're watching live or replay, we love you. Thank you so much. And I'm going to jump right in. So I will drop a link to the full recipe after the live and we're done in the description so you can get that. But I'll kind of, so don't worry if you can't write everything down, but I'll just talk you through it. What you need are, see what we got here first are some water chestnuts that I've chopped up. I also have some garlic and some green onions, and it smells really good in here. And then in for our sauce, I have some hoisin sauce, some tamari, which is gluten-free soy sauce. You could also use shoyu or soy sauce. You could also use coconut aminos if you have a soy allergy. And then we are also, and there's some brown sugar in here as well. Oh, and sriracha. That's what makes this spicy, sriracha. So you got that in your sauce. We're gonna whisk that together in a little bit. And then we have some tofu here. I have just drained it. It's firm tofu. I'm not pressing it. You want it to be soft so you can crumble it. I like the firm tofu for this recipe because I like it to have a little bit of, not a bite, but a little bit of texture to it. If you prefer the silky tofu, you can do that as well. And you can also do the super firm tofu. But we're gonna crumble it up and make like a tofu wrap. Now, I know I have a lot of our members have family members who are not plant-based or who are on different diets. So you can change this up, obviously, with ground chicken, with ground beef, whatever type of protein you like. And if you have a soy allergy, you could do this with like chickpeas or I'm truly thinking on how we change it up. I always have alternatives for soy-free, nut-free, gluten-free, and ditch in the oil. Every week we give you alternatives for how to customize the recipe if you have certain dietary restrictions. So we do have an option for you if you wanted to switch out. I'm just totally blanking on what it is right now, so I'm sorry for that. I'll link to that in the description as well. And then when we go to serve it, this is the fun part. As I mentioned, we have our brown sushi rice that we recommend serving this with. And then we have some butter leaf lettuce. I have some fresh mint, and I have some green onions, some cilantro, and some lime wedges. So, and you can, we're also going to make a little dipping sauce you can make to dip it. So to get started, I'm going to put our oil, and I am going to put this all in. Now you guys, my love language is food. Food is my love language. And I always make and develop all of our Batch Cooking Club recipes with a lot of love. But this one is going special love, special dedication to my Gabby. I don't think she's watching right now. But she loved these lettuce wraps when I created them for Batch Cooking Club. I test everything on my family because we are a family-focused company, and where we aim to please the whole family. And kids, that means kids, we're looking at you, the pickiest of all, right? The harshest critic. And she loved these. And to get a thumbs up from my 17-year-old is like gold. And she's having a surgery tomorrow, and so this is going to be perfect. I'm making this batch for her so she can have it for lunch the next couple of days while I nurse her back to health. So this is for you, Gabby. So this is cooking. Well, this, you guys wanted to get obviously aromatic and a little bit softened, and then we're gonna crumble in our tofu. And as I mentioned, we have our kind of glaze sauce here, and I'm just gonna whisk it all together. It's about a quarter cup of soy sauce or tamari, which is what I use. I try to go gluten-free as much as possible in my house because it feels good, better to me. But you do you. And we've got 2 tablespoons of brown sugar. We have the hoisin sauce, which was, I think it was 2 teaspoons of hoisin sauce. Again, don't quote me on this. I'm going with memory, which is never a good thing with me, but I will link to the full recipe in the description. And then you have your sriracha, which is to taste, depending how spicy you want it. If you don't want it spicy at all, you can completely omit it. Okay, so that's the sauce. And I want to talk a Pacific Standard Time. And that's so that you can plan, finish your meal plan between Wednesday and Friday, go to the grocery store on the weekend, maybe Friday or Saturday, and then meal prep on Saturday and Sunday. And when I say meal prep, what we do is we give you 4 dinner recipes for the week, but then we also give you 4 to 6 additional recipes that you can prep on the weekend to speed up those dinners. So for example, we would prep this recipe that I'm showing you for the spicy Asian style tofu. We're batching that on the weekend. That's one of the 4 to 6 recipes, along with the brown sushi rice. So then when you go to put this together during the week, all you really have to do is put together your lettuce leaves, your lemon, your lime wedges, all that stuff on the platter, heat up your rice, heat up your filling, and dinner is ready in less than, 15 minutes, 10 minutes? So that's how we simplify dinner and help you speed it up. Get us a little good. So that's one example. We also this week have on the menu, we know that it's Thanksgiving week. Can you guys believe it? I'm gonna now, ooh, that smells so good. Now I'm gonna just crumble in the tofu. And there, this is very scientific, you guys. I'm literally just going to use your hands, make sure your hands are clean, and I'm literally just crumbling it with my hands. There is no special technique here except rip and crumble. So anyways, as I was saying, it's Thanksgiving week. So we anticipated that many of you are going to be, in addition to having to do your daily dinner prep, are also going to be doing your Thanksgiving prep. And if you need some help with that, you should go over to batchcookingclub.com/holiday-checklist, I believe it is. I put together a checklist for how to divide everything up. But I do have a suggestion of how you break up your Thanksgiving prep. I shop typically on Mondays, do my sides on Tuesdays, do my pies and my like dips or appetizers on Wednesday, and then I just have to do my like salad and veggies on the morning of, and so I can relax on Thanksgiving. So anyway, I digress. So in order to kind of help you next week, figuring you're gonna have a lot of Thanksgiving prep to do, we, set up this plan this week so that you pretty much, if you wanted to, could prep everything on the weekend so dinner would take you no time at all. And we're not about getting in the kitchen and doing it all on the weekend. We really believe that you set up your plan and you sync your meal prep to where you need help the most. I love to cook. I enjoy it at the end of my day, but I don't want to think about it at the end of the day. I don't want to have to spend too much time. So having a plan that's already done for me ahead of time with Batch Cooking Club speeds that work up. So, in addition to the lettuce wraps with the brown rice, we also have a winter salad with caramelized baked tempeh, which is an amazing salad. If you need a salad for Thanksgiving, this is a great one. And you make the tempeh and the salad, the shallot vinaigrette, I'm going to say it's my sister. So you have your dressing and the tempeh all done, so you're really just throwing the greens together during the week. We also have a sweet potato and black bean chili, so you're making that on the weekend as well. So again, another done-for-you meal, one and done. And then the other one was, cheesy tempeh and tater tot bake. So we always include, okay, so now we're just going to let this sit for a little bit. We want it to get a little golden. I'm going to, the tofu can get like a little bit of a golden, it's not meat, so it's not going to get totally golden, but it's going to get a little bit of color in there. So that's what we're going for. So the tempeh, we always include in every Batch Cooking Club prep plan for the week, a double batch of something that we use in 2 ways. So that caramelized baked tempeh that I mentioned that is going in that winter salad with the Dijon shallot vinaigrette, we're using that tempeh as well in this cheesy tempeh and tater tot bake. Now that recipe, for all the members who are listening, that recipe is not on your prep plan for the weekend, but you easily could do the sauce on the weekend and get it all ready and then just pour the sauce on right before and bake it. It's super simple. It's got a layer of the tempeh, a layer of vegetables, top it with the tater tots, you could top it with potatoes, you could top it with any kind of, you could just do a vegetable and tempeh bake too. But sauce is going to have to come up with like 10 other ways to use it because it just came out very good. It's almond milk based, but you can easily make it nut-free by using a nut-free plant-based milk. I highly recommend Ripple. That is one of my favorite. It's a pea protein, so that's an option for you too. So those are the recipes. That's the menu for the week. Again, it's spicy Asian tofu lettuce wrap with brown sushi rice, some sweet potato and black bean chili, the cheesy tempeh and tater tot, cheesy tempeh and tater tot bake, and then the winter salad with the tempeh and Dijon shallot vinaigrette. So that's what we have for you for the week. You can check us out at batchcookingclub.com, and you can also try us free at batchcookingclub.com/free, and you get a free week to try us out and try our plan. You get access to our private Facebook community when you join, so you get extra support and encouragement. If you're new to creating a meal prep routine and you have no idea what I'm talking about when I'm talking about syncing your schedule to your meal plan and coming up with a prep plan on the weekend, then we're happy to work with you, and we'd love to support and encourage you, and that's what we do in our private Facebook group. I'm there live weekly to cheer you on. So I'm just going to give this another little stir. Now for serving this, I showed you my platter, but you can also make a dipping sauce, because what's going to happen is we whisk this together, right? And we're going to pour this into the tofu in just a second. And then you're going to cook it for about 2 to 3 minutes until the liquid gets absorbed and it really infuses flavor into the tofu. And so then when you go to serve it, though, you have all this great stuff, which is amazing. But by the way, I have butterleaf lettuce wraps here, but I just discovered at Trader Joe's something called jicama wraps, and they're very thin slices of jicama. I've been using them every week in tacos for my Taco Tuesday, but they would be amazing with this. You could use these jicama wraps for that. So Trader Joe's doesn't pay me. I just love them so much and all the unique and innovative products they have for plant-based. So anyway, when you serve this, you can also make a really quick, easy dipping sauce. You can just do 2 tablespoons of your tamari or your shoyu or coconut aminos with a tablespoon of sesame oil, and just whisk that together, and you can serve that on the side, and then you can drizzle a little bit of that on top if you wanted more flavor. I find personally just this with a squeeze of the lime juice is plenty for me, but if you wanted to do that, we have that in the recipe as well. Okay, this is smelling so delicious. Oh, and if you have questions, please shout them out below. Let us know where you're cooking from. Let us know what level of batch cooker you are. We love to connect with you. And I will answer those either. If I can get to you live, I will get to you after, I promise. Okay, so I'm going to pour in our sauce to the mixture over here. And like I said, we're just going to let this infuse the flavors, or infuse the tofu. And as you can see here, I continue to break up the tofu with my rubber spatula here. You do not want big chunks. You want it to be really broken up like you would in your traditional lettuce wraps. These are really inspired for me by P.F. Chang's. I really love their tofu lettuce wraps, so this is a shout out to P.F. Chang's. I love your wraps, and I'm trying to recreate them myself since I can't come to your restaurant right now. Okay, so this smelling looks so good. And you just want to keep breaking it up into pieces, and you want to make sure you stir it well so that the mixture, the sauce, is completely stirred through and every little piece of tofu is getting their grip of sauce. Okay, so we're going to let that sit for a few minutes. And that's really just 2 minutes and we're done with that. And that's how quick this is. So you can see by making how easy, how much it simplifies your dinner prep if you do a few things on the weekend. So that's why we're doing this on the weekend. We're doing the brown rice, and then dinner, we just got to put this little platter together. That's it. So what else do I want to tell you? We have some fun things coming up in December. We gave a little preview to our members, and I'll give you a little shout out, a little preview as well. We have gift options for the holidays. just prepared for the onslaught of, you know, holiday merchandising commercials and sell. So we're getting in with the holiday spirit of giving the gift of Batch Cooking Club. For $10, you can buy a Batch Cooking Club membership, but you can also gift a Batch Cooking Club membership, or you can purchase our annual for $100. If you go to batchcookingclub.com/gift, or just go to batchcookingclub.com, you'll see a big box that tells you all about the gifting, and you can click on that and it'll take you to a beautiful page with options to purchase gifts. We also have a free gift for you. Any purchase made between November 23rd, which is Monday, through December 31st, through the end of the year, we are gifting you a holiday gift guide with exclusive deals and offers on some of my favorite cruelty-free, non-toxic products to make your holiday shopping easier, but also maybe buy yourself a little something for the holiday. So it's our little free gift of purchase. You get this exclusive gift guide. You won't find these offers anywhere else with these companies, and I'm so excited to have such a great lineup of companies participating. I'm gonna be sharing more about that next week at Batch Cooking Club on Instagram and on Facebook. So check us out at Batch Cooking Club if you're not already following. All right, so this is all, you can see this is all of the liquid has been absorbed. There's no more, you know, it's all been combined in there and it's smoking. So we're gonna take it off. And this is how I like to serve it. I'm, you know, making it a little fancy, but presentation is key, right? So I would serve this on the table for dinner with the brown rice on the side, and I would also maybe make some, again, I'm shouting out Trader Joe's, maybe they should be, tofu, or their pot stickers. They have really delicious pot stickers. They have vegetable ones, they have chicken ones. I think they even have beef boiled pickles. So this recipe feeds four. The serving size is four, but I have to be honest with you, I could eat half of this. So that's, but if you add the rice and if you add some pot stickers, I might even do an additional big like Asian style salad. Trader Joe's also has a really delicious carrot ginger salad dressing in their refrigerated section, so you could serve that, like have a big salad in it, and like, there would be plenty of options for the whole family. So, here we go.
We have a question by Marsha from Washington.
Hi, Marsha.
Is there a substitute for hoisin sauce?
Hoisin sauce. That is a very good question. I do not know it off of the top of my head, but I know that we have one in the ingredient substitution guide, which is a great way to get me to talk about that. We have an ingredient substitution guide that we update every week with every ingredient that we have in our recipes. We give you an alternative. So I know hoisin sauce is in there. I just can't think of what it is. It might be a blend of like, you make your own little blend. You could probably just skip the hoisin sauce too and use like a store-bought like Asian marinade or something like that. Like you could probably, I'm going to say soyaki, but that already, you've already got tamari in there, so that's a lot of soy sauce. But anyway, sorry, Marsha, I can't think of it right now, but I will ping you later. I'll look it up in the ingredient substitution guide. All of our members get that guide every week. It's updated in their library, so that's another thing that we do for you. So you don't have to worry about picky eaters, because also right now, some ingredients can be unreliable, and you don't know what you're going to find, so we want you to be able to be flexible and, you know, use what you have if you need to. So that's that. Any other questions? No questions. Okay, everyone, thank you so much for tuning in. We obviously will not be live next week because it will be Thanksgiving, and I will be busy preparing my family's feast. I might, if I can swing it, I might tune in live. I have a favorite appetizer that I love to make each week. I'll just tease that, and I might pop on live if I'm able to double it all. I would love to show that and share it with you. So if I can swing that, I will do that next Thursday around the same time. Otherwise, I will see you the following week, which is, I think, December 4th, maybe? I can't even think of the calendar. We're going to be happy holidays to you. Have a wonderful Thanksgiving. Thank you so much for watching, and we will see you not next week, but the following week.